Hey there, my name is Lexi Carrier, and here's my colleague Catherine Sanders, and we're here today to inform you on how to be an MC for like pep rallies and talent shows and all that. First of all, it helps if you have a loud voice, because obviously you have to amplify your voice over the whole student body. In addition, you gotta be outgoing, because standing out in front of the whole student body is a little nerve-wracking, I must say. But from my past experiences as an MC, I would definitely say what you have to do and what you can't do. I remember my last MC, I said, before you go, and everyone stormed out, so I would avoid using the words going or entering or whatnot, just kind of be clear and concise without. Another helpful insight is to know what you're going to say before you say it, because when we have those papers that we're reading off of, like a kind of like a pep rally itinerary or MC itinerary, we end up like forgetting and messing up what we say as we're saying it because we weren't properly prepared. So just make sure you're prepared ahead of time, which helps a lot. High school students are a tough crowd, so be sure to be able to relate and make funny jokes that will bring everyone together. It's kind of fun to hit an inside joke, especially at like the MCs, because all the teachers kind of are in disbelief while everyone else knows what's going on. Here I have a special guest with me to share some advice on how to be a great MC.
I'm a great MC.
What special tips would you like to include on our fellow students on how to be an MC?
Make sure you know what you're talking about. Know your audience.
There you have it. Great.
Great words. Move quickly through the agenda, and it's not about you.
You heard it from the best, Dr. Shelton.
Watching our How to Be an MC guide. Stay tuned for our next how-to.